All right, welcome back to Get Real. I am your host, Erin Thomason. I am here with Sarah Baer of Ross and Corey Patricelli with LaMacchia in Worcester. Welcome, Corey.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here. So, everybody listening, you don't know, but Corey has been in the salon business for like 25 years. And in order to make things more comfortable here, she's doing my nails right this moment.
Yes, I am. We're doing a lovely coral color.
we're getting ready for the spring market with our spring colors,
yes,
right?
Yes, it looks fabulous.
Exactly.
I'm next.
Oh, there you go. Perfect.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, are you going to do the same one?
Yeah. I've had my nails painted since I was six.
This is what it's like for me daily.
Yeah.
This is a lot of talking about real estate when I'm at the salon.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I'll answer all the questions that people have during their one-hour visit with me.
Mm-hmm. Well, I feel like the person that knows everything about you is, you know, whoever you see at the salon, or your realtor, because then they're right in your home, which is right in your business.
Yes.
So and so now you're both.
Exactly.
And you've actually done really well at that. So you're probably not going to toot your own horn, so I'll toot it for you. You know, you've been in for about 2.5 years, and you're doing great.
Thank you.
And you're pretty humble, but I think that's probably because you're a real people person, and you have a lot of relationships that you've built over the years. And I think that really parlays well into the real estate world because it's all about people, right?
100% true. I like to build a connection with the clients, be available for any questions they may have, whether it's to do with salon business, real estate, anything in general. If I can help them, if they need a referral to a contractor, a plumber, anything like that. I feel like I want to be the go-to person for any of that type of stuff.
Yeah. And Corey, we spoke earlier. You realistically, you've built a trust network throughout the years, and even your, you know, 2.5 years in real estate right now. So one of the best things and one of the coolest things I think about you personally is that you have your own concierge people that you trust. So you have a buyer, you have a seller coming to you. If they need an electrician, they need a plumber, they need an attorney, you have people that you've trusted and worked with year in, year out.
At my fingertips, on the phone, I'll shoot them a text, a call. Most of the time, they'll answer right away. I've built a great relationship with that person that I'm referring my clients to, so I know they're going to be treated with respect, honesty, and communication is key with me.
So you're only one person, right?
You one know? Person.
Which people might not know, but
it's unclear.
Yeah. I love to work.
Yeah. So your team that you're on right now at LaMacchia, how has that helped you in your day-to-day business? You know, do you have availability to other realtors, to your broker, you know?
At all times we do. If I am busy with something, I will call. I can literally call my assistant or send a quick email. Her name's Megan. She's awesome.
Megan.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
nice job, Megan.
Shout out. And she helps me on a day-to-day basis with a smile.
Yes.
Even if I'm over the top, she knows how to manage me personally with things that I have to get done. So I have her. I have my attorney, Ken Jenkins, who I use all the time, different vendors. I do use Guaranteed Rate a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Ross, Shant, they're great. Brianna Kelly with Total Mortgage. These are people that I've developed relationships with and trust to get the job done and treat my clients well.
Okay, so you have a high standard for the people that are helping your clients as well because you hold yourself to a high standard.
Very much. I ask my clients, how did that call go? How did you like the people? So that's also part of the trust building with the vendors that I use.
Yeah, and it's all about, you know, also care and concern. You know, you mm-hmm. like to be working with the people
yes.
that are helping your clients, but, you know, as far as you with your specific clients, there's times when you've gone above and beyond to help, you know, one little area here or there if there's issues.
One story in particular that comes to mind that's pretty funny is I had a sale in Holden, and the seller, we became friends almost. She had a dilemma at the very end of the sale. They had a 90-gallon fish tank.
Oh, boy.
And she was trying to get this fish tank moved in a certain amount of time, but it's very delicate, a saltwater tank.
Mm-hmm.
And literally at the end of it, I'm like, listen, if you need to put the fish tank in my house, we can store the fish tank at my house. That's
which
fine.
I'm sure your husband was thrilled about.
Yeah.
How are we gonna get always this wanted a temporary 90-gallon fish tank, right?
90 Who gallons. Doesn't? And then who's going to be coming to service this fish tank at all hours?
Yes.
You know? But I will make deals happen and go the extra mile to help buyers or sellers get to the point where they need to be.
Yeah. Now, you talked about how you help a lot of first-time buyers as well.
Oh, I love first-time home buyers because they look at you for any knowledge that you can give them. I will try to set them in a direction where they can be successful, move forward. Do you have someone that you're working with for a lender? I can give them advice on what the next steps are going to be, what if they're going to put an offer on a home, what the sellers are going to be looking for, what the sellers agents are going to be looking for in an offer.
Mm-hmm.
So they have knowledge. We talk about home inspections, what to expect if you're buying a house that is, you know, from 1950. It's not a brand new build, so there's going to be things that are wrong with the house, and we have to try and work around some of these things, possibly an older roof, an older furnace.
Mm-hmm.
I'm always saying, like, call Mass Save. I have people that do roofs.
Mm-hmm.
We'll go through the house and, you know, when they mm-hmm. go and see it, and hopefully we can get the deal to work if they feel yes. comfortable.
Even some other things, I think, too, like directing them to maybe a lender that would provide the particular loan that would work best for them, not
yes.
just, you know.
Yep.
Because everybody needs something a little different, you know.
Yeah.
And a lot of times, you know, for VA, for example, they think that you can only go to specific
yes.
lenders for VA. Maybe it has VA in the name, and they're like, oh, I have to go there. When, you know, in reality, that's not the case. And you might have somebody that you work with that you know will give great service, and they're, you know, they're local. And even simple things like they don't know how much home insurance is supposed to be,
yep.
you know, and they might not know if it's way up base, you know, yep. way more than it needs to be, which can affect everything else. So I think that it's really important to guide them through that whole process.
I'm working with VA buyers and also first responder buyer right now,
mm-hmm.
actually.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, they're doing fantastic.
Yeah.
And
yeah, I think what it comes down to, too, is which I will say, you know, being in the business this long, working with realtors and seeing what other lenders do, is that there's a missing portion to helping buyers and helping sellers, and that's education,
mm-hmm.
right? And Corey, you're very well rounded on what work needs to be done, what they need to know as far as buying it or selling. So you're not just taking them out and showing them a house and then calling it a day and thinking it's fabulous. This process to you is very emotional because you know that on their side it's very emotional as well. Yeah. So the education portion of that is something that you do extremely well.
Yes. If we're going to look at houses in a town I'm not familiar with, you better believe I'm pulling up comps, looking at what's sold in the past 6 months, looking at all the pictures,
mm-hmm.
make sure my offer is going to be in the range of what the comps were. So I'm protecting my buyers we're not overpricing what they could.
Mm-hmm. And if there's good restaurants.
Yeah. Right. You know about restaurants.
Yeah.
I know about all this stuff.
Yeah.
Right, 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 right.
What goes on in these towns?
Yeah.
One thing that you mentioned, too, before we started recording is the HGTV generation.
Oh,
you know,
yes.
And it's so kind of adjusting,
yeah.
you know, expectations.
I forgot. I have something to add. So when I'm at a listing appointment, which I love listing appointments, I have a lot of them, I'm super structured and I have a certain way I love decorating, and I can pinpoint some things that might help the seller get more money, or
mm-hmm.
just a simple mm-hmm. thing like painting a bedroom
mm-hmm.
really makes a difference.
Mm-hmm.
I have access to interior decorators that I will call whether they need one room done, and I work on budgets. So I'll have my interior decorator come with me to a listing appointment if the seller says, yeah, that sounds great, Corey.
Mm-hmm.
And she'll go through the house, tag all the furniture she can use to make the pricing better for them.
Mm-hmm.
Also, if the house, say, is vacant, this is mainly mm-hmm. what I'm using because I do have a lot of houses that are vacant that
yep.
pictures look like, what room is this? Everything looks the same.
Right. Do some staging.
If I can put in bed, you know,
yep.
they put in the beds, the kitchen tables, everything like that.
Yep.
the house can be priced more. Once yeah. it's done, you'd be amazed that you walk in, you're like, wait a minute, I want to update this price a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and mm-hmm. I think for sellers especially, you know, they're thinking in their heads, oh my God, I have to paint this or I have to change this. And they try to do that before they even meet with you. And then it turns out to be a waste of money because it might not have right. gotten them
right.
the value that they needed. Rather, where you're now teaming up with an interior decorator yes. and yourself, you have the knowledge.
If we don't have money in the budget to do full-on interior decorating, mm-hmm. I do offer virtual staging.
Mm-hmm.
I use professional photography all the time. Medora mm-hmm. Photography, absolute favorite, hands down. They come in, do videos. I could do drone videos, virtual staging mm-hmm. on in-houses too, which mm-hmm. they
make. Which is pretty cool.
Oh, yeah. You should see my newest listing that just got launched today, condo, and it's virtually staged.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, mm-hmm. yeah, and it's furniture that's two sides in the room. We're not going to put a twin king bed in a bedroom that only could fit a twin.
Right.
Yeah. So it's made to look.
It's made for size so people yes. get a realistic view
yep.
of well, what a room could look like.
And that's the point, is to like help people see the vision, you know, yes. like look beyond, you know, the whatever it is
it's
that they don't like and see what you can do. Yeah.
Into an empty house.
Very
and,
hard.
Mm-hmm. And figure out where they're going to put furniture. Mm-hmm. It really is. Not everyone has that.
Mm-hmm.
look of, you know, where they could decorate or
right.
what colors go with what, how where, how am I going to put a couch in this room? Like,
well, I think colors are important too. Like Sarah mentioned, maybe they try to do the work before you show up so that they're ready, but maybe the choices they made were a little too specific to their own tastes. Yeah. And when you're trying to appeal to a wider market, you know, maybe the color they chose or the material they chose was just not a great mm-hmm. investment, and maybe it's, you know, something yeah, we need know. To change
with pink. Clutter too.
Yeah,
with listings, I remind the seller that we are going to be moving out soon. Right, you're going to be
right.
moving out soon.
Right.
So if you take something off of the wall, put it in a tote. Mm-hmm. So that tote's going to be in a moving truck probably mm-hmm. in 3 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
So let's try and declutter a little bit.
Yeah,
that helps a lot. We have to make it so that the buyer walks in the house and can envision themselves living there.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, that's good too, because then they have a head start and they're moving. So it's like yeah, taking the stress right. level down yeah. a little bit just in preparing for that, which is good.
Mm-hmm. I try and put in ideas.
Yeah.
Even plant seeds sometimes. Mm-hmm. With sometimes not everyone is open to doing these things that
mm-hmm.
once I leave, then they might change their mind a little
yeah.
bit.
Sure.
And when people are, you know, you're going into house to sell it, especially now with this low inventory in the market.
Yes.
Are you seeing a lot of people that are cautiously optimistic about selling and buying at the same time?
So that's a tough one in this market. So I have someone in particular right now that I'm working with. They want to buy in Shrewsbury, sell in Fitchburg. There's not a lot of houses on the market for them to
buy. Yeah, buy Shrewsbury right is now. A tough right. yeah, area to get into.
So it's for school systems and yes. things like that. So what I recommend is always we put home sale contingency on their listing. We have them ready to go. I do floor plans, pre-list, which gets shuffled over to Megan. So she writes up my listings, and that allows me to work both jobs.
Mm-hmm.
And then also I organize the photography, whether I'm going to do videos, pictures, depending on the location of the home. And then I have everything ready in a folder where I can press the button
live,
like,
let's go. Yeah.
And then on the other side, where I'm submitting an offer in this market right now, it's going to be hot already. It seems like spring market's here.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
The other side feels confident to be able to accept an offer like that because my listing is ready to go.
Right.
It's being launched. My clients are comfortable because they're possibly getting their offer accepted and they have everything ready to go.
So you're beforehand, you know, they're looking at houses and whatnot, but you're doing the preparedness in the beginning to get the pictures done, get your listing all set to go live. So when they actually do find a home, there could be a home sale contingency that they could possibly make an offer on.
Right.
And now, how does that make it stronger for your buyer as far as purchasing that home? Say they were looking in that Shrewsbury. You can talk to that other agent and say, listen, I have everything ready to go.
Yep.
We're going live on the market. Yep. As soon as
and it gives them a higher level of confidence, yes. I think, once, you know, if they see that you're prepared and that the seller is prepared.
Yep,
so
definitely 100%.
Yeah. You can kind of take kind of a unsure situation and make it a little bit more comfortable
sometimes
for everybody.
Sometimes how I turn it will be, this is what I'm going to do to sell your house.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to spin it this way too. How would you feel if I accepted an offer that the sellers weren't prepared?
Right.
They're on the other side.
Right.
So I will spin it around and then it's easier to understand.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So listen,
do you like that I'm talking with my hands right now and no one can see me?
She's talking with her hands, everyone.
Yeah.
And only one of my hands is painted because she's quite distracted.
Yeah.
But that's good. That's good. Real estate takes precedence here. So before we run out of time, I just want to give out your contact information. It's Corey Patricelli with LaMacchia in Worcester. Her number is 774-696-6662. And you can text or call anytime. She did admit that, she'll jump off the treadmill to take a call.
Stop eating dinner with my husband.
Her poor husband is terribly unhappy and neglected because she does it while they're at dinner. So just kind of in summary for you, I think what comes across for me is that you are a people person. You care about people a lot. You develop long-term trusting relationships with folks that you meet. They become your friends. You shared that your very first listing was with a friend. And do you want me to say your name? Cindy.
I'll tell you about that.
Okay, you tell us.
So one of my long-term clients at the salon, when I first joined, I had another brokerage I worked for, one of my very good friends. He got me started. And then my client, Cindy, said, "Hey, Corey, I want you to sell my house. I had just started. This would be my first deal as a listing."
Mm-hmm.
I was super nervous. And she said, "Corey, I'm not going to have anyone else but you. So just figure it out
and get going. Just do it.
Get her done.
I'm very confident in you. Do not worry. Let's go." And sure enough, the house sold. My first transaction. I was super excited. I see her every 2 weeks. We still talk about it. We laugh that that was my first transaction.
And you're still friends.
Yep. And I've done about how many deals have I done now? So 2.5 years, about almost probably 50 deals.
Yeah.
So buy and sell.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of different price ranges. I work with any buyers or sellers, all different price ranges and surrounding towns for Worcester County.
So you've come a long way since then.
Yes.
But you started with just being you and you're still you.
Oh, yeah.
And You had said earlier that you'll do whatever you can to just make things easier on your clients.
I like
clients,
to
so.
Be real, keep it comfortable. Mm-hmm. There's not a lot of pressure, and I will get the manage the whole transaction for the client on either side.
All right. Well,
so
if you want to,
yeah.
I mean, I think anywhere in the Worcester County area, call Corey Patricelli for LaMacchia in Worcester. First time buyers, sellers. Double-sided clients. She's ready to do it all. We'll be back after this with more Get Real. But in the meantime, I still have 2 fingers left. So can you finish
that
up?
Yep, I'm going to finish those up.
Thanks a lot. Thanks, Corey.
Thanks
Sarah.
All right. Thanks, ladies.